I left my fear by the side of the road. Hear you speak, it won't let go. Fall to my knees as I lift my hands to pray. Got every reason to be here again. Father's heart that draws me in. And all my eyes want to see is a glimpse of you. All I need is you.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, and hallelujah, and another hallelujah, amen. What a blessed day it is to be in the Lord, amen. We are here in the Dallas-Fort Worth district. You know, I'm just welcoming in the Holy Spirit here today. I know that we flow into the spirit of things, amen, and God is always, always, say that with me, always, ever, so present in our time of need and even want through that special presence only that we can receive through our Lord Jesus Christ, amen, who is our Savior, hallelujah. You know, the presence of the Lord is so powerful, even though, yes, it is raining, as they say, very hard, amen. You know, they say cats and dogs, but I'm here to say that you are so very welcome, Holy, Holy, Holy Spirit, amen. God is such a holy God. I believe that He is using this time, this space, and this area in which we live in, even now, you know what, to cleanse and to wash and to purify not only the hearts and lives, but really the whole wide world. You know, let it rain. Let it rain. That's a way that purifies and cleans and washes, you know, that sameness which we shall have to have that move in the spirit. Are we hearing that? Are we understanding that? Having the sameness of the hearingness of knowing that God is moving in the spirit, and that same power and that same anointing as Elijah and as Elisha from those times past, that God's come, spirit will come and it's so fullness and the power. See, we know that God's presence is here. I'm not saying that God's presence is not here. Now, don't take it out of context. Because the Spirit of the living God, where two or three are gathered in His name, He is there. We got the angels that encamp around us. We have the Holy Spirit, amen, that leads us, that guides us. We have the person of the Holy Spirit, that where we can hear, that we can touch, where we can feel, that we can know through prayer and through seeking God's word and through the Holy Spirit. We know that He's here. The presence of the Lord is here. But it's something different when the presence of God, when His Shekinah glory, when the Holy Ghost, the fire. Come on now, I'm feeling the fire today. I'm feeling the fire today, church. When the Spirit of God permanences in a place and literally takes hold and shakes the house down. I'm talking about Holy Ghost fire. And I believe that that's what God is even doing today. He is doing a lot of shaking. He is doing a lot of baking. You know why? Because God is purifying. He is cleaning His church. He is cleaning our hearts. He is cleaning our minds. You know what? If this is a step, because even water, come on now. Water will even keep people back from doing evil. Water will keep people back from doing something they shouldn't be doing or going somewhere where they shouldn't be going. Oh, it's rainy. I ain't going nowhere. You see what I'm saying? Sometimes, but we need a Holy Ghost water. We need a washing of the heart, the washing of our minds, the washing of our heads. You know what? We need a, you know what? It's not only Calgon take me away. It's, you know what? Give me that borax. I need something good to cleanse my mind, to cleanse my conscience, to cleanse my heart. And there's nothing, nothing better than the Word of God. And especially when the devil is attacking us in our conscience, when the devil's attacking us on our bodies, when the devil's attacking us on our finances, when the devil's just get down and just really beating up over our heads about, you know what, you don't even know who you are, you don't even know where you're going, you don't even know what the next step to take, you don't even know what's up, what's down, what's all around, you don't even know nothing. I'm just saying what it is. You know, I even asked my father here. Many know that my father has been a pastor for many years. And now he does a lot of ministry, different streets ministry. Amen. He's fellowship with another body as well. And you know what? Until the Lord has him there, you know what? Let it be. But if he has him to do something else, you know, because I believe that that ministry is birthed inside of each and every one of us. And you know what? When you're not welcome, you know what? God will remove you and he will place you and he will put you somewhere else where you can be respected and you can be honored, not only as a woman of God, but as a man of God. Amen. And you know what? Sometimes you'll get a lot of naysayers, but when God has you there, you'll have the grace to stay there. But you will see productivity, you will see growth, you will see anointing, you will see the flow of the Spirit. Hallelujah. But you know what? When it's time to go, hey, I gotta go. You know what? I just gotta go. You know, what good is it to be hidden up your head or your hand or your feet up against a rock that's just not wanting to break? Now, we know he talks about putting that hammer onto that rock, but the Word of God is the hammer. But if you don't allow me to take the hammer out, come on now. Come on now. If you don't allow me to take the hammer out, what am I doing? You see, we all have a calling. We all have a destiny. We all have a purpose. We all have a plan. And that plan is according to God's perfect plan and his perfect will for your life. I'm telling you that God is moving and God is shaking. He is bringing us up to a next level, and then the next level, and then the next level. God has put a word into my spirit. He is saying, be perpetual. That means it's a consistency. It's day in and day out. You're coming in. You're going out. You're doing. You're going. You're flowing. This is you. Are we listening? Hey, this is the way it rolls. This is the way it goes. This is the way it be, says the Lord thy God. Hallelujah. You know why? Because he is the one that prospers you. He is the one that made you. He is the one that created you. He's the one that put the fire up in your bones. I'm telling you, I'm preaching down. Don't shut me down while I'm preaching good. I'm telling you, you feel like you're at a movie theater right now. Just come on now. Just eat that popcorn. Eat it up. Eat it up. Eat it up. I'm telling you, we are eating the Word of God today because God is doing a perfected work within our lives right now. Right now, we are working out that prophetic word in our lives. And that's how God wants us to be. You know, He doesn't want us to be wishy-washies. It's not about being wishy-washy, you know? Sometimes we hear it, the wash on, the wash on, the wash off, the wash off, the wash on, the wash off. You know? No, we need to be in a constant. I know that many of y'all that received a podcasting not too long ago, how we were talking that we don't just go in circles. We're not talking about going around that mountain one more time. No, God says that we go from glory to glory to glory to glory. We go from victory to victory to victory. We go into His presence. We go into His presence. We go into His presence. We go from strength to strength to strength. We go into His glory, and more glory, church. And it's a spiral that is going up. It's not a spiral that's going down. And it's not a spiral that's viciously going in a circle that's going nowhere. No, God has special plans and purpose for your life. He has destined for your life. He's called you out. He called you out by your name. He knew you while yet you were in your mother's womb. He foreordained you. He ordained you. And He's saying, for such a time as this, says the Lord. I mean, God is speaking and mouth full. I see the horizon. I'm telling you, church, I see the horizon. Because God's word and promises are yes and amen. Now, I'm telling you, I'm going to take you to scripture. I'm going to take you to scripture because I'm not just blowing hot air, and I'm not just blowing, you know, just to create something. I know that because I serve the Creator, that I know that I can create. Come on now. But what I'm saying, that God's word creates an atmosphere. And this word creates an atmosphere. That, you know what? That you are a doer of the word. And God's word and God's presence premonishes where you are to take you to the next level as you trust in Him and as you have your being in Him. Yes, you may see it on a bird's eye view. You may see it far, but I'm telling you, it's what's inside of each and every one of us that we take it unto an account. We call it forth, where it manifests, and it manifests unto life, where it has the being of the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, I'm not here to be Confucius. I'm not here to bring confusion. I'm not here to bring frustration. No, I'm here to bring a promise. That promise that is saying that God is not finished with you yet. I'm telling you, we're on a work in process. We're on a work in process. We're on a work in process. Are you listening? We're on a work in process. You know, God doesn't want the children, the people to God, to live under guilt and shame. That's why we have repentance, and that's why we have confession, that we can come before the Lord. You know, I was reading here at the book of Psalms, chapter 32. As you read there out of the book of Psalms 32, we see the life of David on how he feels so bombarded with transgression and with sin, that he realized that, Lord, even as I kept silent, my bones were wasted away through my groaning, even all day long, for all day and all night, that God's hand, it was heavy upon me. In other words, God's going to complete the process over and in your life. You may feel a little heavy laden for the time. You may feel the little pressure. You may feel the little hurt. You may feel the little pain. But God is saying, in that hurt and in that pain, you know what, church? I'm going to process you. I'm going to make you. And you know what? Just a lot of people say that he won't break you. But sometimes we're already broken. Sometimes, you know what? We're just pieces. We feel like fragments. But I'm talking about, we serve a God of restoration. We serve a God of wholeness, that he just don't crumble you up and plant you out. No, he gives you a brand new sheet over your life, that we don't have to live under past failures, past mistakes, past mishaps, past whatever. Whatever someone may have called you, blackbird, hippo, button up. I mean, I don't know. I don't know what was your nickname. But I'm telling you, there's a promise. And God is here to fulfill the promise in your life. Yes, you may have been forsaken, forsooken. You may even felt like, you know what? No one doesn't love me. But I want you to confess over your life that God loves you. I want you to look in the mirror and say, you know what? I love myself. Because a lot of times we don't even know how to even love ourselves. You know, I shared with someone today, you know what? I'm celebrating myself. I'm celebrating me. Hello? And they said, girl, what you doing with those cow boots on? I'm going to take some pictures with that. What you doing with those cow boots on? Where are you going special? Where are you going? They got the state fair going on. Where are you going? What you doing? I said, you know what? I'm celebrating myself. I'm celebrating myself. And they said, you know what? That's a good idea. And I said, you know what? Because we need to celebrate ourselves. We need to do that more often. And if you can do that every day, come on now, don't shut me down. You can celebrate yourself. It's not ignorant to celebrate yourself. And it's not, you know, making yourself to be high and mighty all by yourself. No. I'm just saying that, you know what? Attitude, character, your life. You know what been you've been around. You know everything that what you do. You know, because I, even Sister Tina, find myself at the end of the day with the last of the stick of the day, the little morsel, the little crumb. And sometimes I do, and I give out so much of me and my time and even my strength and my force and finances and anything and that of everything, because I know that's what I'm called to do. I'm called to serve. I'm called to give. I'm called to have my being. But you know what? I've learned that I have to celebrate. I've learned how to celebrate myself. I learned how to celebrate my being. I learned how to say, you know what? I know where I am right now. I know where I am right now. But if I want that oneness with God, when I want that commune with the Holy Spirit, you know what? I got to be like Jesus. I got to draw away from everybody. I got to draw away from the mess. I got to draw away from the naysayers. I got to draw away from the haters. Come on now. I got to draw away from things that are hurting my mind, my thoughts, my patterns. I got to break the cycle of men. You see what I'm saying? And connect to the only Savior, who is the Lord Jesus Christ, the only God. I posted it the other day, the one true God. And there's one mediator, and that's through the Lord Jesus Christ. There's only one God, church. There's not a universal God. There's not a humma, humma, humme. You see what I'm saying? There's only one God. There's only one Savior. God, the Lord Jesus Christ. He is the one true God that came and manifest himself over and for our lives, each and every one of us. And he went to the third heavens to intercede for me. In other words, we have a great intercessor that is praying for us in the heavenly realms. And he said, you know what? I go to be with the Father because I'm going to leave you a comforter. I'm going to leave you a comforter. He didn't say, I'm going to leave you the troublemaker. He didn't say, I'm going to leave you the highways and the byways just to kick the can. No, I'm going to leave you a comforter. And you know, when you draw and you seek the Lord, you're going to find him. And so I'm drawing you. I'm oozing you into the things of God and into the things of spirit. Because I want you to know that you have a promise, you have prosperity, and you have life written all over you. You know, I did a great research on salt yesterday. And salt represents life. But too much of the salt, too much of the salt can represent death. But that's a whole nother subject. But what I'm trying to share with you, that God has called us to be the salt to the earth. I'm going to share with you, and I've already shared a little bit about a Psalms 32, amen. But I'm going to share with you there at a Psalms 33, where the word of God, it says, by the word of the Lord, there in Psalms 33, there in verse chapter 6, the word of the Lord, where the heavens were made, the starry hosts by the breath of his mouth, he gathers the waters of the sea into jars, and he puts the deep into the storehouses. Amen. He puts the deep into the storehouses. Church, I'm talking about the deep things of God. I'm talking about, you want to rid away that shame. You want to rid away that guilt. Get into the repentance of God. Get into the confessions of God. And ask the Holy Spirit to come to wash, to cleanse, and to make you whole, to purify you. One more time. The word of God says that he puts the deep into the storehouses. Let all the earth fear the Lord. And let all the people of the world, let him revere him. God wants us to have a reverential fear of the Lord Jesus Christ. For the word of God says, for he has spoke, and it came to be. In other words, it came to pass. He commanded and it stood firm. In other words, God commanded, and what God commanded, it came to pass. Are we listening? For he spoke it and it came to be. I'm saying that again. I'm talking to some people right now. And I don't know who I'm talking to, but I know that I'm talking to you. I'm talking to myself. I'm talking to those that are choosing, who want to hear. Are we listening, church? For the word of the Lord is right. For the word of the Lord is true. He is faithful in all what he does. All through that scripture, all through that Psalms 33, God has promises of those things that are in the deep. He reveals the things of the storehouses. He says, let the earth fear the Lord, and let all the people of the world, let us revere him. For he spoke and it came to be. He commanded and it stood firm. Now I'm going to pray with you. I feel like I'm going to pray and then I'm going to go back to special points in scripture. Church, I'm letting you know here today that God loves you. He has not forsaken you, for He has an undying love. It's an unfailing love. That maybe you felt like you've made many mistakes, many challenges, many heartaches, many failures. But God is a God of the second, the third, the fourth, I don't know, however many chances. But I know that He says that even for us to forgive, how many times we should get, we should forgive, we should forgive. Even 40 times 4, with 40, we should forgive. We should trust. We shall believe. Why, church? Because we're believers. And because we trust in Him. That God is the one that has our back. And He is the God of the unfailing love, that He surrounds us. You know what He told me? When I was in His presence, He said, you know what? I am surrounding you. I am surrounding you with songs of deliverance. And I said, thank you, Jesus. He said, because in your spirit, there is no deceit. In other words, I'm open and I'm receptive. And God is saying, don't be sorrowful, but rejoice. Rejoice in His presence. Rejoice in the King. Rejoice as Philippians speaks in chapter 4. Because He says, rejoice. And again, I say rejoice. God wants us to rejoice in His presence. Once we've known that we have that complete repentance, that complete confession. You know what? That sorrow will break over your life. And God will bring you into new horizons, into new hopes. Come on now. I feel like God is saying, put out a scope. Because there is new hope. There's new direction for you, even in your life. Are you willing to go there? Are you willing to walk to my promise? Are you willing to go where no man has gone before? Maybe no woman has gone before. You know, because once again, I said that I can create because I serve a creator. And I believe that God has ordained you to have creative ideas. And He can do those mighty works over and in your life as you trust Him. You know, He's given you this open window for you to receive extra finances, extra support, extra love, extra, extra, extra. Read all about it. Extra, extra. God has given you your extra. Right now, your storehouses are being full. Come on now. But now God is saying, with all this extra storehouse, I want you to do what I've called you to do. I want you to expand. I want you to extend. I want you to put in what I have given unto you to do, because there's work to be done. And as that work is being done, I am going to manifest my life for you. And you will receive the hundredfold return. You will receive the recompense of your obedience. And you're going to see the horizon come more. You're going to see that more light shall come. You're going to see that the glory of the Lord will shine more upon your life. You know why, church? Because God says that may your unfailing love rest upon us, O Lord, because our hope is in you. You know, I love this word of scripture. I love this word of scripture. And I'm going to end with this, but I'm going to share with you, and I'm still there at Psalms chapter 33. And God's word says, for he spoke and it came to be, that he commanded and it stood firm. For the Lord foils the plans of the nations, and he thwarts the purposes of the people. In other words, God's going to hold back the plans of the nations as well as the people. Because, check this out, the plans of the Lord stand firm forever. These nations can plan whatever they want to plan. The people, presidencies, governments can plan whatever they want to plan. Are you listening? But I'm here to tell you today that God is saying that he is shouting, he is blowing his horn from the mountaintops, that we will see the greater revelations and manifestations of God's promises here upon this earth before we leave it. Because every eye will see and every ear shall hear and know through this word of God what I am speaking today. Because even those that would choose, check this out, church. For even those who choose to want to even cause death, check this out, upon themselves, there will come a day that they will want to die and they will not even be able to even die, nor even hurt themselves, nor even kill themselves. That the rich will even try to climb up the highest mountain. It says that there will be those that will even try to go to the highest mountains to hide under the rocks because of God's glory and the vengeance. Are we listening? The vengeance is mine, says the Lord. God will bring a day of vengeance. But the day and time of the vengeance of the Lord will be the time of the glory for the church. And see, that's where we are messed up. Because we believe that we are going to be trapped into death here on earth. You see what I'm saying? I'm trying to really be careful with my point and really fine for y'all to get an understanding. But what God is going to do is reveal his glory and his power and his manifestation. The same power that moved before Christ through the prophets. Amen. And through those in through the nations, God's glory will come in the same manner. Raising of the dead, making the blind eyes to see, making the lame to walk, bringing resurrection, life once again. But God is choosing to use the body of Christ for his fullness, for his glory, and for his manifestation. So that's not the time of the church to be weary or to be heavy laden. No, that's the time of God's Shekinah glory that will be revealed and will manifest. Just remember the days and the times of Moses. Are we listening? Because in the times of Moses, church, everything was happening in the land of the Pharaohs when God's people was being greatly protected. But they had to be what? Exactly done as the Spirit of God had led them when they had to offer the sacrifice of the lamb with no blemish, when they had to literally put the blood over the doorposts. Amen. And so there is still application of what God is speaking over us and in our lives to do. Amen. Amen. And I'm going to share with you through the word of scripture. I sought the Lord and he answered me and he delivered me from all of my fears. And those who look to him are radiant. Their faces are never covered with shame. Amen. They're never covered with shame. And I'm going to end with this word of scripture. And then we'll go back to prayer. But the plans of the Lord stand firm forever. And the purposes of his heart through all generations. Blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord. Let us pray today. Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Lord, we know that you are doing a work even in this nation. But even as you are doing a work, Father God, we ask you not only for your mercy, but your grace. That your grace will expel and expand upon your people, Lord, here today. Father, because your mercy and your grace, it's new, it's brand new. Every morning you give us an opportunity, Lord, to repent and to make it right before your throne, Father God. For even the littlest of sin, sin known and sin that's not even unknown, a guilt that is not even there. Sometimes we may even have a guilt conscious that's not even there, just like the Lord has showed me. He said, blessed is the man whose sin the Lord does not count against him and whose spirit is no deceit. There is no deceit. Church, there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus our Lord. So, Father, as we come before you, Lord, you see us in our nakedness. You know us from the very crown of our head to the very soles of our feet. Father, I pray that you may have your way over and in our lives as never before. Father, we see the day of redemption drawing nigh, Father God. Father, may our focus and our eyes be set on you, Lord Jesus. That all of these things of this world do not pertain to us. But Father God, it is of you. And it is all of you. And I know that it is your will that we may prosper and increase not only with our government, but even all of our naysayers. Come on now. Father God, your word even promises that you've set us a table even before all of our enemies, because you've still anointed our head with oil that our cup overflows. In other words, you will not give us more than what we can bear. But Lord, that us as individuals, that we will carry our cross here today, and that we will love you, because everything that you have so, that we have so journeyed unto this time, everything that you've given us, even unto us right now, Lord, that we just in turn, we give it back to you, Lord, because you are our King, you are our Lord, and you are our Savior. Father God, you are the one that upholds, as we read, the stars in the sky. So how much more would you care for us, or that you will uphold us? Father God, you said that our names are written in the palms of your hand. How much more will our lives be upheld in your hand? I thank you, Lord, for your awesome presence. I thank you, Lord, that your word is true. Father, your word stated that it stands firm and it stands forever. Father, I even pray for the White House, for our presidency and those in government, those in leadership. Father God, I pray that you would draw all men unto Thee, Father God, and that they will see you, and that they will know you, and Lord, that you will set the captive free. For it's not by might nor by power, but by your Holy Spirit, says the Lord. And so not only do we lift up this nation, this great nation, the United States of America, but Father God, I know this word goes international, and we pray for all nations. We pray that all will come to the feet of Jesus. Father, we come all into repentance and asking of forgiveness of all of our sins, because I know that you not only look to a people as a nation, but you look at us as individuals. You look at us and see us for those that are of the light and those that are the darkness. And I pray, Father God, that there are many, many that are in the valley of the shadow of death, that are many in the valley of decision. Father God, I pray for increase. I pray for the laborers, for you to send each and every one of us in to bring forth more light, to bring forth more glory, that Shekinah glory, that increase, that surmountable abounds of righteousness and peace and joy of the Holy Ghost. I thank you here today as we come not only as a people, but as nations to repent before our Lord and our Savior, the only one and true God, who is Jesus Christ, our Lord. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. We know that you're not finished with us yet, Lord. And I thank you, Jesus, that you're working out that perfect process in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You know, I believe that God is speaking, and I am seeing in vision of just a great rainbow, and God is saying that my promises are true. I know that the land will suffer. Amen. I know that there are going to be earthquakes. I know that there's going to be disasters. I know that there's going to be hurricanes. I know that there's going to be floods, because they already happen in church, and they're happening more and more and more and more as our time is drawing nigh unto God. But this is the gospel of the Good News Church. And the good news is Jesus is coming for his church. Jesus is coming for his body. But he is saying, look up, and know that your Savior, your Deliverer, your salvation draws nigh. And so keep your focus on Christ today. Amen. Please, church, I'm asking you, share this word on your page. Share this word through your messenger. Share this word. I want this word literally to go viral. Amen. Just all around the world. This is not a time to be afraid of sicknesses and diseases. You know what? If you want to stop sicknesses and diseases, we need to send the word of God. And people will get doses of this word. Because God's word, check this out. God's word says that his word is like medicine. Are we listening? It is like medicine to our bones. Hallelujah. And I want God's word to go viral. Hallelujah. So God bless you, church. Visit the website and make your choice. Make it be wise. And I want to thank you in advance for all the love and support, as well as your prayers. Amen. Until next time, church. God bless you and your family and all of your loved ones. Until next time. Amen and amen.